Back again with another review, Dave Fire. So now, full disclosure, I typically tape these episodes several months in advance. And it's critical to this because last year I sort of stumbled into this with this brewery when I did their Christmas ale last year, because just through sheer luck, I was able to find it and time it right for Christmas. I'm not going to time anything this year. I'm filming these on December 30th, this first set of reviews on the 30th. I'm going to do another one on New Year's Eve. And that's critical to why I'm drinking this particular beer right now. It's from the Shawfly, or however you pronounce it, brewery, which admittedly, it was in St. Louis. It is in St. Louis. And admittedly, I should have visited there when I was in St. Louis. I regret not doing so. Not to say that I don't regret going to Four Hands Brewery. If you're in St. Louis, go to the Four Hands Brewery. Their beer is amazing. But when I saw this, I just couldn't resist the name. Shawfly Merry Berry Ale. Now, I've made my feelings clear on stuff like Wild Berry. Because it's like too generic of a name for my preference. And again, I know there are people who like Wildberry. I don't like Wildberry. I also don't like peaches, Game of Thrones, Stranger Things. I don't like a lot of popular stuff. Yeah, it's got a good scent. But I'm not really getting the berry. Now, I'm expecting like a berry Weiss, but it's got a good overall flavor. I mean, don't get me wrong. But again, I'm not tasting the berries here. That said, this is a really good beer. It doesn't have that much of an aftertaste, and it's not overly bitter. I'm just not tasting the berries here. You know, it's sort of like when I tried the ginger ale version of grown-up soda, and I blasted it because it didn't taste like ginger. Maybe that's just me, but if you're going to advertise something as berry-flavored, I want to be able to taste the berries. Not subtly either. Yeah, it puts me in a weird place in grading this, because if it didn't mention the berries, to be genuinely honest, I wouldn't even notice. But, again, it's advertised as being berry-flavored, and I'm just not getting the berry flavor. Okay. So since I have two more of these reviews to shoot tonight, I'm going to put this one on the back burner for a little bit. Because I really do want to get to these next two. You know what? Fuck it. I'm giving this an A. Even though it doesn't have the advertised berry flavor, it's a damn good ale. Not very bitter, not very strong, no aftertaste, no bitterness. They literally could make this year-round and just change the name. I would buy it. Definitely. Definitely. This is awesome. I would normally say, well, go out and get you some right now, but this has probably been long discontinued by then, which is sad. Because this is a damn good product. All right, we're going from Chicago. We're going from St. Louis to Chicago. For our next review, it's been a long day. Dave Firestone, see you then.